Hello everybody and welcome to part 6 of the Python for Finance tutorial series, and in this one we're going to cover the candlestick or open high low close bars with Python. So what we're going to do is we will import what we need, we will get the data, we will structure the data in a way that we can use to create these bars, and we will see how we can do some resampling, how we can do some modifications, but also how to read these bars. So from the previous tutorial I actually just left four lines. One is for the style, then the starting date, the ending date. Make sure, let's use a ticker to be equal to Bank of America, and the line to get the data from Yahoo Finance. So we start with almost no code from the previous tutorials. Now from MPL Finance, so MPL underscore Finance, we're going to import candlestick underscore open high low close. This is what we need to create this candlestick bar. What do we get when we run this web.dataReader? So what are the information that are stored at the moment in our initial data set? Well, what we have is we have our date as being the index, and we have high, low, open, close, which is what we need. We have the volume. Let's make use of that as well. Maybe there's some correlation between these, the volatility and the volume, and the adjusted close, which in this case we are not going to use, although we can use actually adjusted close, but I think this is completely fine. If we use this, that's completely fine. So we need to create our data set. So the open high low close would be equal to data, and then open high low and close. Now know that if I take the first five results, or if I print the hat of open high low close, we still have this date as the index, and this is something that we need to keep in mind, because when we are creating the open high low close, we need actually this date not to be the index, but to be one of these columns, and we will see that later on. Because if we just use this, well, it will say that the error that we get is we have four columns, but the Python expects five. So there's one column missing. It's same as if we have date, open, high, and low, and if we don't have the close included. So keep in mind that we need these five, which we have the data, but we need that to be none of them to be indexed. So what we need to do first is open high low close dot reset underscore index, and in place is true. So now the date is no longer the index, but the index is just 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. That looks fine. Now we have five columns that we can use to create these candlestick. There is something else that we need to do when it comes to the date, but maybe let's run into that issue and then we'll see how to solve that. So we have the data stored in open high low close. The volume, well, we have that anyway stored in our initial data, so we can use that. So let's create our grid and our plots on the grid. So we have two plots. The first one would be, so PLT subplot to grid. The first one would be, so the output would be, we would have one plot on top, which would have the open high low close bars, the candlestick bar, and the one below would have the volume bar. So the first one, let's create the grid being 6 by 1, so 6 rows 1 column. The first one starting from the 0th row 0th column, so it starts from the very beginning. It spans, so row span is equal to 3, col span is equal to 1. Now what this means is that we have 6 rows, so row starting from 0, so 0, 1, and 2 are reserved for this first axis, and ax2 would be equal to plt.subplot to grid on the same 6 by 1. This one would start by 4, so row 3 we would leave empty, row 4 and 5 would be reserved for this second plot, which would have the volume. All right, and share x would be ax1, and we do this, so if we zoom in on one, we automatically zoom in on the second one as well. Now how do we use this data that we have to make sure that it's displayed on this AX1? So So candlestick underscore open high low close, that's what we have at the moment. AX1 comma open high low close dot values, and this is all that we need to make sure that these are the values that are being plotted on AX1. Now let's try to, I'm going to comment this reset index for a second just to see that error that we would get if we don't have the data included. And ax2.bar would be, let's say data.index and data volume. We can also make sure to add some labels just to add some more information. So when the data is shown, it also, there's some information what it means. So for the first one, for the open high low close, I'll set a Y label, which would be on the Y axis. And the comment would be open high low close. For the second one, I'll set Y label as volume. And AX2, I'll set X label to know that the X axis we have date. And let's use plt.tite underscore layout and show. Well, we'll run into some errors, but let's see how to solve them one by one. Now, as you can see, we get a value error, not enough values to unpack, expected 5, but got 4. And this is the reason why we need to have the date as part of our data set, because as we said, open, high, low, close, what we have is 4 columns and date being the index. Now, if we reset the index, now this error is something that we are going to not face, but there's something else that we will face. And the issue here is that the date needs to be in a given format for this candlestick open high low close to use it. And as you can see here, we have unsupported operand type for timestamp and float. Now, how do we solve that? Well, we already have this m dates, which we can use to format dates, and that's something that we need to use. So open high low close date, we need to make sure that that is equal to open high low close date, so the same one, but we're going to map that m dates dot date to num. Now if we do that, we create numbers from the dates that can be used to create these plots. Let's see if we run into any other issue, or that should be fine. All right, so I have my plot popping up on the second screen, and let's see how this looks like. Okay, maybe we have quite kind of long period. Maybe we can take 6 months should be enough. So let's do it like this. So 2020 from 1st of, yeah, you can use June, I think in this case is fine, and let's use until 30th of October. It would run also a bit faster for the tutorial, but it's also much easier to see the plot. So now what you will notice is this is actually what we expected. So we have the open high low close, we have the label, we have the volume on this part, we know that this axis is related to the date, we have year and month, so that's fine. And let's zoom in part of this just to check what it means. So one thing you can see is the color coding. So we have black color as being the default for the days when the price went up, red for when the price went down. Now, how do you read the candlestick? What do these mean? Well, you have one line, which is a very thin one, and that represents the movements on the price. So that is the top of that thin line is the high, the low part is the low. So this thin line is basically the high and low, or the volatility within that day. This bar, which is a bit wider, that one represents the open and close. So it doesn't matter what the stock price was during the day, but what was the open and close price. And the question is, well, which part is open, which part is close? Well, you can see that based on the color. So in this case, we have a black bar, which means that it went up. So this bottom part is the open, top part is close. Now the next day, this was the open, this was the close, and so on. So this is how you can read at least the candlestick bars. Now, I personally don't think that this color coding is ideal. So what I'll do is, as part of this one line that we use, you can also have color up to be equal to, let's use green. I think green is fine. So green is more connected to up days. And for the color down, I'll leave it as it is. I think the default of that is already fine. But if you want to change that, you can just have color down equal and then whatever color you think is more appropriate. You can do the same for the volume, but in this case, you don't have color up or down, it's just color. Let's use blue. Now, if we do that, we have a bit of a different color coding. We already saw what the candlestick means. But if you take a look at how it, let's say the data points, we have quite a lot of data points, and sometimes you don't want to analyze it at the everyday data, but maybe the weekly data. So now, what can we do to make sure that instead of having data for every day, we have data for, let's say, one data per week? In order to do that, we need to resample. So we need to take the data for 7 days and treat it as being just one data point. The way to do that, and I think this is the easiest way, would be instead of defining open, high, low, close as being the open, high, low, close, we can have the adjusted close, and then we can resample that 7 days. So it's actually seven calendar days, not working days. And then dot open, high, low, close. So what this does is basically, and you can use this 30 days, I think you can also use 1 month or something like that. So it takes the adjusted close and it creates this open, high, low, close out of the adjusted close prices per week. And that's all, actually all we need is just changing this initial data set, because everything else is basically coming out of that data. Now, this is, it answers the question, how do we have less data points? Now this is fine, so we can see that this week was quite volatile compared to the next one. So the next one, it was much less volatile. However, if you take a look at the volume, we still have the information of per day. And yeah, it's a bit more difficult to compare our weekly with daily prices. So weekly volume with daily prices, or the other way around. In this case, it was daily volume with weekly prices, but we need to make sure that that's also aligned. So what I'm going to do is I'll create volume just as a separate variable, which would be data volume. And what we did up here, well, we'll do the same. So resample 7 days, except we don't want the open, high, low, close. We want to summarize the data within that period. So here we have the volume, which is for the entire week, and we can plot that to see how that compares with the open, high, low, close. And maybe some days when, some weeks when we had higher volume, there was also a higher candlestick bar. I hope that makes sense, but if you have any questions, just let me know in the comments below. So now we need to use this data, the volume, the one that we just resampled, and use that in this ax2.bar. So we can replace, instead of using data volume, we can just say we want just volume, which is fine. But keep in mind that the index, which is our x-axis, at the moment is data.index. And that contains the dates for every day. And that's a bit, well, you can't use that, because if you try to just change the y values, this is what would happen. You get an error which says shape mismatch. And whenever you get this error, just think of, okay, so you have some shape. In this case, it's plotting the x-axis and the y-axis. And it doesn't have the same amount of data points on both axes. And that's exactly the case here, because the data index has the everyday dates, while the volume has less, so 7 times less, or actually 5 times less points. So what you can do is volume.index, and that would solve this issue. Now, if you're thinking, well, why didn't we get that issue by this part up? Well, because when we did the resampling, we adjusted for that initially. So we did a resample, and also we're using this part that, so the candlestick open, high, low, close takes all the values as being columns. The bar takes the index as a separate one and the volume as a separate one. And we could have done something similar. We could, but we need to reset the index, and then here the, instead of volume, it would be volume date. And I think this is a bit maybe easier to do. So what we would expect is to have one data point, and there we go. And this is actually, it looks much nicer than before. If you take a look here at the beginning, the volatility is, this part is, let's say the volume is higher, and also the volatility is matching that to some extent. This part, let's say around August, there was less volume, less trading volume compared to June, and we can see that these candlesticks are much shorter compared to the candlestick somewhere in June. So that would be all actually regarding this tutorial. You have sufficient information on how to, let's say, which library to be used or what to be used from that library, how to get the data, how to resample it. Again, you can use 30 days, 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, whatever you find appropriate, whatever suits your need. Then you know how to change the colors, color up, color down, and how to change also, this is something that we've covered before, so the Y, X, Y, L, X labels. If you didn't notice where that appears, actually these X and Y labels, maybe that's good to quickly mention. So we have the first one is the, let's say, related to first axis. We have the open, high, low, close. This is the comment that we have, the Y axis, the Y label. We have the volume, and we only have one for the X label. And I personally always use the X label at the lowest axis, because if you use the one the one before, then this date would appear somewhere here. And then I would not be sure, okay, so but what does this second X represent? So I always do it at the last one, especially in these cases when they share axes. If the axes are not being shared, then you might want to have X, let's say X label on this one and also on the second one. But here you can also think of the structure when it comes to this grid. So we created six rows. So we don't see the rows, but these are actually six rows. The first one is taking three of the six rows. So this part is taking half of our grid. So this is 0, 1, 2, then this is three as an empty one, and then we have 4 and 5 for the volume. So this is how you can think of, I have a separate tutorial on Matplotlib if you want to learn more about that. So feel free to check that part out. For the rest, good luck. And if you have any questions, let me know in the comment section below. Thank you for watching the tutorial until the end, and I'll see you in the next video.